today I'm going to do a quick review of a product that really made a massive difference for my skin, and it's by Darphin. I've talked about it in another video of mine, but this is going to be the proper review. By the way, if my hair seems weird, I've got olive oil and I'm about to shower in a little bit, so yeah, if it looks oily, it's actually oil, it's not just because I don't wash my hair. This is called a Purifying Balm, and this is exactly what it is. It claims to smooth the skin, soothe it without irritating it. It has to minimize the pores as well. It balances your skin, it takes the toxins out, it doesn't let any bacteria to cause any spots. You're supposed to use this as a treatment, which means as much as you need to. You're not usually, I think they say that you're supposed to use it like once a week or something. I used to use it every night. It would be really hard to use this in the morning, although you could if you wanted, but if you want to go out and wear makeup and stuff, it wouldn't work that good. It's a blend of oils, and if I read to you the amount of goodness there is in this little jar here, which is actually a really tiny jar, and it's too expensive for the amount of product you get. It has apricot oil and sunflower oil and nutmeg kernel oil, tea tree leaf oil, rosewood wood oil, grapefruit peel oil, sage oil. A lot of good things inside. Chamomile, I think it has chamomile extracts as well. So it's a blend of oils, but it works good for oily and problematic skin. So don't be afraid of it. Yeah, you scoop a tiny bit of it out, you warm it up in your fingers, and then you apply it on the face, but you actually have to massage it into the skin, not just apply it as if it was a moisturizer. So on the first few days, even on the first time I've ever used this, I noticed a difference. I was waking up in the morning and my skin wasn't even oily, it was very balanced. The spots were more calm and soon. I could really see a difference. After a while I got a bit lazy and I stopped doing my massage techniques. So this stopped working as well. So don't be lazy. If you get this or any other treatment that needs, you know, some proper massage, you should really do it, because this is part of the treatment. You can find some videos with the face massage and, you know, some movements that you can do on yourself on YouTube. I found one by Oxford Jasmine that I really liked, but there are some others as well. It didn't prevent my massive breakouts, but that's not a problem of this product, that's my own problem. I found lately so many good products that help my skin, soothe it and control the pimples and everything, but the actual problem is from within, because seriously, I cannot stop breaking out. Right now I'm recovering, but you probably can see a bit of scarring and discoloration and everything. I don't wear any makeup, but I'm possibly expecting another one to come soon, because this is what happens. I get breakouts, then they stop and then they come back, and this never stops. So I thought I should treat the problem from within, and I'm about to go to do a homeopathy treatment next week, so hopefully that will help. We'll see. But this product, I was really happy with this balm, because it did like the best that it could do for my extremely problematic skin, and I'm talking that I had like serious acne. I'm talking about cystic acne. It was very, very bad, but still this actually worked great. It's not a product that I suggest, you know, all of you go out and buy it, because just because it's expensive. It's excellent, but it's bloody expensive, so it's not like any teenager can have access to this. I read a few reviews online. Some people don't like the smell. I personally like herbal smells very much, so yeah, the smell wasn't a problem for me. It's very soothing, it smells like lavender. What I'm saying here is that this works. It's expensive. If you have the money and you want to try it, go ahead and do it. If you don't, you could probably live without it. You can find something else. One other little tip is that, as I said, I was waking up in the mornings and I couldn't feel any oiliness on my skin, but lately I have been feeling a bit of oiliness in the mornings, and I think it's due to the hot climate. Lately we've had really hot weather, and I think it has to do with that. So if you live in a very hot country like I do, you better save this for winter, because it feels like it doesn't let the skin breathe as well. So if you have any other recommendations, right now I'm trying another system of mine. I'm using pseudocreme and it actually works. I don't get really bad spots everywhere. And I'm also using a line by Boots, which is a witch hazel and tea tree line. And I'm going to try homeopathy as well. I hope that will work. I really do. So that was my quick review. I hope you're all well. And I will see you soon.